Hi, everybody, and welcome to our online worship service today. We are so glad that you are worshiping with the Acts of Faith community. We may be based here in Rochester, New York, but we know that there are worshipers all across the country, and we give thanks for the technology that allows us to hear and dive deeply into the love of God through our time together. This is being originally broadcast on Mother's Day, but in our community, we also, you know, recognize that there are many men who are nurturing, protective, and selfless in our lives as well. So we invite you to join us in expanding our celebration as we recognize the many ways that God uses several people to birth us into existence. This is also a Sunday when we are lifting up the image of the Good Shepherd and the ways in which Jesus, God, the Holy Spirit serve to shepherd us throughout our lives and our journeys, not unlike a lot of mothers and mother figures that we know. Our time to ponder this week, to pause the video and either think about it by ourselves, or if you're worshiping with someone else near you, to share your thoughts and memories, follows up on these ideas of Mother's Day and Good Shepherds. When you are ready, release the pause button and I will continue with our call to worship. But for now, let us get our hearts and minds ready to welcome God into our space, wherever we are, as we focus on our centering moment. Sometimes the people who are most supportive, compassionate, and nurturing to us are men. Sometimes they are women. Sometimes they are people we know, and other times they are those we watch from afar or who have a professional relationship with us. Who are some of the people who were the most nurturing to you in your life? Ready? Pause. As we begin our worship on this Mother's Day, let us call each other to worship and invite the Holy Presence to join us wherever we are, whenever we are viewing this. Please read the bold print with me as it appears on your screen. Come, let us worship and praise God. Holy is our Shepherd, our Guardian, and our Guide. Celebrate the many ways in which God cares for our lives. Green pastures and silent, still waters beckon us and comfort us. Even though difficulties happen to us, God finds ways to surround and protect us. Even when it seems that the world has nothing to offer but suffering and pain, we are surrounded by love and bounty. Surely God's mercy accompanies us on our journeys. All our lives, there are people who bring the presence of the Holy to us. We will dwell in God's house forever. Amen. And now let us raise our voices with Andy as we sing our opening hymn.
Blessed Jesus, you walk from sin, defend us, seek us when we go astray. Blessed Jesus, blessed Jesus, hear your children when we pray. Blessed Jesus, blessed Jesus, hear your children when we pray. You have promised to receive us, poor and sinful though we be. You have mercy to relieve us, grace to cleanse and power to free. Blessed Jesus, blessed Jesus, early let us turn to you. Blessed Jesus, blessed Jesus, early let us turn to you. Early let us seek your favor, early let us do your will. Blessed Lord and only Savior, with your love our spirits fill. Blessed Jesus, blessed Jesus, you have loved us, love us still. Blessed Jesus, blessed Jesus, you have loved us, love us still.
Though we are dispersed in many places as we worship together today, the challenges facing us are often universal. Let us share these moments to recognize the world as it is, while we choose to align ourselves with the Spirit of the living God in this Eastertide. Anger, hatred, and anguish blare at us from the newspapers and media. It is easy for the shouts of hurt and pain to harden our hearts, merciful God. We cannot bear the hurts, so we sometimes turn away. When we hide and want the hurt to disappear, you place someone in our lives who reminds us of your love, your light, and your protection. When we hear the words of the psalmist singing about the green pastures and still waters, our souls long for the place of peace. Too often we think that it can be found outside ourselves, yet this is a reminder of the peace and hope that your love offers us from within. We know that we will have struggles and hard times, but reach out to us, Holy Comforter. Invite us to place our lives in your care, to trust in you, gentle Spirit. Replace our blurred vision with the clarity of your compassion as we give thanks for those who throughout our lives remind us not only of who we are, but whose we are. For this we ask in the name of you who are not only the good shepherd, but the best shepherd, Jesus the Christ. Amen. Friends, God's love cannot be contained. May we be its reflection in the world as others have reflected it to us.
Many of us grew up memorizing the 23rd Psalm, and while it is often recited at funerals and memorial services, it also has a message for us in our everyday lives. Using this translation from the International Children's Bible, let us read together in unison of God's constant care and abiding love. The Lord is my shepherd. I have everything I need. He gives me rest in green pastures. He leads me to calm water. He gives me strength. For the good of his name, he leads me on paths that are right. Even if I walk through a very dark valley, I will not be afraid because you are with me. Your rod and your shepherd's staff comfort me. You prepare a meal for me in front of my enemies. You pour oil of blessing on my head. You give me more than I can hold. Surely your goodness and love will be with me all my life, and I will live in the house of the Lord forever.
Today we will be proclaiming the Gospel according to John, adapted from the International Children's Bible, chapter 20, verses 22 to 30. It speaks of the Feast of Dedication, which can rightly be thought of as today's celebration of Hanukkah. And Solomon's porch, which gets mentioned in it, was a beautiful roofed-in colonnade along the eastern wall of the temple in Jerusalem. It is here that we pick up the story of Jesus and his teachings. Listen for the word of God. The time came for the Feast of Dedication at Jerusalem. This was during the winter. Jesus was walking in the temple in Solomon's porch. The Jews gathered around him and said, "How long will you make us wonder about you? If you are the Christ, then tell us plainly." Jesus answered, "I told you already, but you did not believe. I do miracles in God's name. Those miracles show who I am. But you don't believe because you are not my sheep. My sheep listen to my voice. I know them, and they follow me. I give them eternal life, and they will never die. And no person can steal them out of my hand. My heavenly parent gave my sheep to me. God is greater than all, and no person can steal my sheep out of that hand. God and I are one." This is the word of God for us on this Sunday. Thanks be to God. You know, I don't know much about shepherding or sheep herding. Do you? I have a friend who raised ostriches for a few years, but nobody who had sheep. I have friends in Ohio with goats, but again, not sheep. And just to be clear to all of my sheep-loving friends, I don't eat lamb, much to my brother's dismay. Okay, disclaimers out of the way. So recognizing my deficit in the lexicon of sheep knowledge, I set out to learn some things so I could speak with a clear understanding today. You know, the pastorally brilliant comments that will wow you with my knowledge. Even still, I got nothing, as the kids say. But in Jesus' day, especially in that part of the world, especially as they were related to sacred Jewish rituals, sheep were a big deal. Everybody knew about sheep. My late friend, the Reverend Jean Fowler, taught me a lot about how flocks related to shepherds, though. I'd always thought that shepherds just rounded up the sheep and, you know, off they went. I think my internal picture was, you know, more like herding cats, perhaps. The first introduction that I had to shepherds as a community, not being, you know, a professional that practiced in an area where they were around, but not thinking of just shepherds as individuals, came from Giancarlo Minotti's opera, Amahl and the Night Visitors. And there's this big chorus of shepherds, shepherdesses. Now, though, I've learned a little bit more that makes the comparisons of Jesus to a good shepherd all the more meaningful. For instance, for even average-sized flocks, there's more than one shepherd. It takes more than one person, even with the help of a border collie in Australia or New Zealand, it takes more than one person to round the sheep up. It takes more than one person to move the flock. And the sheep choose the shepherd as much as the shepherd chooses the sheep. What do I mean? Well, sheep hone in on their shepherd's voice. So if I visit a friend who's a shepherd with another flock, her sheep won't pay any attention to me whatsoever. And even if I'm working a mid-sized flock with someone else, some of the sheep will respond to my voice while others seem only to hear the other voice. Pretty cool, huh? The sheep come to know that they can trust the shepherd to keep them out of danger, to protect them from predators. I learned from Jean that in biblical times, and maybe it's true today too, I don't know, shepherds would lay their staff horizontally across the shoulders of the sheep nearest to them, and the sheep would feel that presence and be comforted. So as the shepherd walked, the sheep under the staff would walk with him or her, and of course the others, following their shepherd's voice and not wanting to be left out of the party, would traipse right along with the others. And that's how shepherds could move the flock. That being said, I've never quite understood how the shepherds would leave their flocks to go to Bethlehem on the night that Jesus was born. But maybe they had apprentice shepherds who stayed back to protect everybody. Or maybe the angels told them they'd take care of the sheep. We'll watch after these, you go. That always made me wonder a little bit, but I digress. If you were raising sheep, lambs, that would be slaughtered as sacrifice in the temple in Jerusalem, they had to be without blemish. So you really had to be on the lookout for anything that might cause a bruise or an injury to your charges. Ever vigilant, the shepherds were, and are, I imagine. And every time I think about that responsibility, I think immediately of parenting. I remember when my daughter was born 24 and a half years ago, one of my closest friends said, "Well, that's the last worry-free night's sleep you'll ever have." And in a way, she was right. You know, those who nurture us, mothers, fathers, mentors, siblings, sometimes friends, they are like shepherds to us. We recognize their voice. We recognize the truth when we hear them say it. We trust them. They help us to keep safe by sharing their knowledge of the emotional or societal terrain around us. These are the people who calm us down, who give us strength, who walk with us through the very dark valleys. Everything that the psalmist wrote. We have all been shepherded at one time or another. And most of us have been shepherds, whether we put that title to it or not. We still are. Sometimes we're shepherded by people older than we are, sometimes by younger. That's the thing. It doesn't matter. It's all about being with those that we trust, with those who are looking out for us, those whose voice gets through to us when everything else is sounding chaotic and like white noise. And then there's the one who's not only the good shepherd, but the best ever shepherd, Jesus. He's the one who makes it clear, "My sheep listen to my voice. I know them, and they follow me." I love the fact that nobody can steal me from him, as he said. I love the fact that when I'm lost, he drops everything to come and find me. I love the fact that he stays close and is always calling to me because on some level, I know his voice. I feel comforted knowing that even if I screw up or place myself at risk, he will come and find me. He will protect me. That even if I am in the presence of my enemies, I don't really think I have too many of those, so I think of it more like when I'm in the presence of the world, the crazy world values, the outlooks and the temptations that I truly want no part of. That when I'm surrounded by that and they're pushing in on me, that he will be with me to guide and comfort and claim me as part of his flock. Sometimes he may even claim me from myself when I get off center a little bit. And then I think about all those people who have shepherded me. Certainly in my case, it was my mother, my grandmother, my father, my siblings, friends and chosen family, and many of you. You know, we talk a fair amount about how God is without gender. One of my friends said the other day, with all of the attention being paid to gender-specific pronouns now, and you see that on Zoom all the time, you know, it'll be somebody's name and then parenthesis, she slash her, that's what they go by. That maybe we should be using they and them to talk about God, because it includes the whole Trinity, Creator, Christ, and Spirit. What I will say is this. When I think of God or the Spirit as female as opposed to male, when I put God in terms of mothering me and birthing me, I get an entirely different image. Those words elicit different emotional and even muscular responses in me than just God the Father, which, by the way, I do relate to on occasion, lest you think otherwise. But on this day, when we are honoring mothers and mothering in this country and lifting up shepherding, I want to end with an extremely talented musician and arranger, Bobby McFerrin, who recorded a different kind of version of the 23rd Psalm dedicated to his mother. It is an amazing combination of our two themes for today. And so I offer you this rendition, which can also be found as is on YouTube.
The Lord is my shepherd, I have all I need. She makes me lie down in green meadows, beside the still waters she will lead. She restores my soul, she rights my wrongs, she leads me in a path of good things, and fills my heart with songs. Even though I walk through a dark and dreary land, there is nothing that can shake me. She has said she won't forsake me. I'm in her hand. She sets a table before me in the presence of my foes. She anoints my head with oil, and my cup overflows. Surely, surely goodness and kindness will follow me all the days of my life, and I will live in a house forever, forever and ever. Glory be to our mother, into the Holy of Holies. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be. World without end.
May we all give thanks to those who have nurtured us, to those who do nurture us, and to the greatest shepherd of all. Amen. Now, I know many of you may want to pause the video for a moment, or even go back and listen to Bobby McFerrin again, or to just sit and let that feeling of that song stay with you. But when you are ready, we will sing together what may be a new hymn to many of us. I do think, however, that we will be able to pick it up quickly as Andy leads us in this statement of God's love for all of us as a child rests. Andy?
As a child rests in its mother's arms, so will I rest in you. As a child rests in its mother's arms, so will I rest in you. My God, I am not proud, I do not look for things too great. As a child rests in its mother's arms, so will I rest in you. As a child rests in its mother's arms, so will I rest in you. My God, I trust in you. You care for me, you give me peace. As a child rests in its mother's arms, so will I rest in you. As a child rests in its mother's arms, so will I rest in you. O Israel, trust in God, now and always trust in God. As a child rests in its mother's arms, so will I rest in you. As a child rests in its mother's arms, so will I rest in you.
Let's just take stock for a minute of the times when we have been the lost sheep. And yet, there were people who found us and brought us back to the love, back to the light. And then let us give a special gift today in honor of those who have nurtured us throughout our life, remembering from where all of our blessings flow.
Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise God, all creatures here below. Praise God above the heavenly host, Creator Christ and Holy Ghost. Amen.
Let's dedicate ourselves and our gifts. Please pray with me. Savior, Shepherd, Messiah, we know you by many names, O Christ. Your presence fills our lives. All that we are and all that we have comes from you. All that you do declares your love for us. Take these gifts, we ask, for we dedicate them to your use as we dedicate our lives to your service, to be shepherds for each other in this world and beyond. Amen. Prayer time. Let us go to that place where we meet, the holy. Fill our hearts, Jesus, as we pray to the Mother and Father of us all. O Christ, you are the Shepherd and our guide. You lead us through the valleys of our everyday lives, and we long to hear your voice calling to us. We long to hear you calling to us to be our best and truest selves. On this day of remembrance, we pause for a moment in silence as we call to mind those who have mothered us into existence through their tender care and abiding love, through believing in us, men and women alike, teachers, preachers, family members, neighbors, strangers, friends. Hear us now as we lift their names in thanksgiving. We ask your blessings on this world, sweet Jesus. Be with all who suffer and mourn. These are such terribly hard times. Laugh and dance with those who celebrate and give thanks. Help us to respond to your voice and to know you deep down. To know that we are loved. We are cherished. We are accepted. And we are yours. And if and when you place us in the role of shepherding others, whether we are aware of it or not, guide our steps, guide our commitment to them. Give us the judgment needed to not lead any of your sheep astray, fill us with the courage, the vigilance, the fortitude and bravery needed to be for them what you and others have been for us. For we ask these things as well as those that are too deep for words, those prayers that we hold in our hearts that we have yet to give voice to. We ask them and we offer ourselves to you. We ask them in your name as we pray with one voice from many places, saying, Our God, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Our closing hymn for today reflects our faith. My shepherd will supply my need. Andy? And so, my friends, we've all learned a little bit about shepherding today, I dare say, or at least about sheep. I invite you to take this feeling that you have right now of being loved and surrounded and cared for and led and guided and supported and never abandoned and sought after and welcomed home. Take that with you throughout this week, because that's who you are to God. It's just all-encompassing, complete, enveloping love and acceptance that changes our lives from the inside out. God never told us to change and then I'll be there. God's love is here, and that is what changes us. Let's take that out into the world so we can change others, change the way this world is going. Just give people the hope and the knowledge that they're not alone and that they are part of this huge flock. All they have to do is listen for the voice of the shepherd and know that they will be protected. So, my friends, go with God, walk with Jesus, and live in the Spirit. And let the people of God say, Amen. Until next time, when we hope to see you either with prayerful pause or another worship, God bless, take care, and bye for now. Thank you. Thank you for joining us today. Wherever you are on your spiritual journey, you are welcome here, and we are glad that you chose to worship with us. We are grateful for your prayerful support of our ministries. We are a small congregation of about 50 members in upstate New York, but now we find ourselves growing to include some of you in North Carolina, Connecticut, Florida, Kentucky, Utah, Colorado, Arizona, Pennsylvania, New Jersey, and other parts of New York State, and maybe other places that we are not even aware of. All of us united by the Spirit of the living and loving God. If you are watching this, we already think that you are part of us, and we would love to hear from you. Should you find yourself in the Rochester, New York area, we would welcome you to worship with us in person. Please check our website calendar for the nearest location. If you would like us to pray for you, please send those joys or concerns to me through our website, which is noted at the end of this video. More worship services, as well as our weekday meditations, Prayerful Pause with the Pastor, can be found on our YouTube channel, South Church Rochester. If you are in a position to help support us financially, your gifts may be sent to us as seen on your screen. We hope that you have a great week, and we look forward to seeing you back here again. Just remember, transform your spirit, transform our world. Okay, God bless, and bye for now.